This is Happy Hour, and right now we're going to be doing a segment where we interview different artists in the area, specifically the Huntsville, Alabama area, and probably will spread eventually as we cover the grounds. So my name is Happy. I'm a budding recording artist and a graphic designer. Got my partner here.
You can call me Thankful, and I'm the armory or weaponry. Got the weapons for you.
All right. And our guest today?
I'm Diamond. I'm a cosplayer, a budding TikToker, and a dancer. I recently got about 75 TikTok followers last night, and it was really amazing because I did this one video. It was like, if you have any daddy issues, get in the bag. And so I was like, get in the bag. And so she's like, if you have daddy issues, get in the bag. So I kind of like just jumped in the bag. It's like one of those duet things. And overnight, I got like 167 likes. And I was like, wow, I did not know I was getting that many likes. And so, and overnight, I got like the 67 followers. And so if you want to follow me on TikTok, I'm a Kaleidoscope chick, and check out me for that.
All right, awesome. All right, so my first question is, what is your art in three words or less? All of the different talents that you're good at in three words or less.
I'll say dancing, cosplay. You know, right now I'm still kind of like a budget cosplay because I'm still learning the ropes. And I don't really have a third one right now. I'm having like, I would like to do voiceover, but I haven't really practiced as much. So I can't really say I'm a voiceover artist right now. So just for now, I'll just say dancing and cosplay.
Dancing and cosplay, that's pretty good. Any questions over there?
Can you do sign language?
Milk? I know like milk, and I think thank you. I don't really know a lot because I haven't studied. I know
this
some. I know some letters. Z. I don't really know it well enough to say I'm a sign languager. I just know a few random things.
Okay, I just
it was because we watched one of your videos and you were doing a lot of this, and he said, "Oh, she could do sign language."
Oh no, it was like a weird thing. It was like.
I mean, I think it'd be very cool. Like, with the sign language kind of time.
I don't think it was really sign language. I was like a conductor, you know, like in an orchestra when they're like doing like this. That's what I was trying to do, because I think the video he's talking about is where it's like, fellows, repeat after me. La da la da da la da 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 da. Was it that one?
Yeah,
that I would like do it with my friends, and it was like I'm just conducting, being all proper and like, but I wasn't sign languaging, I was just conducting like a orchestra conductor.
Okay. All right, so the next question is, what is your biggest goal as an artist?
My biggest goal would be to travel around the world and inspire those with what I want to do, because you don't see a lot of black people in the cosplay community, so I want to be like another person to get out there and say black people can do this too. And we also get a lot of bad things saying like black people can't cosplay because they're not black, they're white, and they're like, well, Asian, so we'll get a lot of bad stuff saying, like, you're a black cosplayer. So once I say anybody can cosplay, no matter if your disability, if you're a different race, if you have all these different things you can't do, so anybody can do it, so I want to inspire people with cosplay. And also, one of my biggest things for dancing, I want to travel on the world for dancing too. There's this group in California called the Corpse Dance Crew, and they have like an anime, musical arts, musical theater, and they're very amazing professional style dancers, and that's what I would like to do, go to California and join them for like maybe a year or two. That's my biggest thing for a dancer too.
Okay, any questions over there?
Sounds pretty good. Sounds like she wanna do her own type of thing, like, sounds nice.
All right, so the next question is, what inspires you about your art?
And inspires me when I find different people on the internet that do the same thing I do, or just find something that they do that I would like to do. That inspires me because there's a lot of, I'm still finding a lot of new cosplayers that I haven't seen before on Instagram. And for my voiceover, there's a lot of ASMR voiceover actors too on YouTube that I really enjoy, like Akira Dubs. I really like him. He does a lot of anime guy voiceovers, and he's like spot on most of the time. His Levi is like that. So if you want to find Akira Dubs on YouTube, you should follow him. And he also does a lot of inspirationals within his stories. It's not just about the lovey-dovey role plays. He does a lot of inspirational when he's in the character too, and he also does a few just not even in character, just saying I inspire you, like you're worth it, you're beautiful, you matter, those types of things. And I really like him doing that too.
Okay, awesome. Any questions? Okay. So at Trigger Happy Production, we try to incorporate all different types of art, and as we grow, we want to have like a type of position open for every type of artist. So if we could give you your dream job, what would it be?
Probably help me to raise money to get where I need to go, and probably help me raise money for the equipment I need for like when I start voiceover, to help me get the equipment for voiceover acting, or maybe lessons, and maybe help me get the funds to go to California for whenever I get the audition for the Corpse Dance Crew, and maybe something like that.
You can jump on that train, run through here, and go to California.
I don't have the funds for that. And
no,
then
he's talking about hopping on the train.
Just hang on and watch your legs.
I don't want to get on the train and hurt my life trying to get down over state to no, over the country. No, I don't want to hurt myself to try to
help with the cosmic thing.
No. I will do it the safe way and with either car and or plane to get there. I don't want to risk my life on the train. Thank you. I will do the safe way. I just need the funds. Just help me get the funds and help me in my practice of trying to get there.
All right. And our final question, besides just your links. So we have a thing called the Location Transformation Project, which is where our clients can go from not even knowing what they want to do with life to choosing which business and starting up a business to becoming their own CEO and star of the show. So in that service, all of our clients or all of the affiliated businesses will offer a service that those clients can choose to use, like a class or, you know, digital design or some kind of service. So if you could offer one service that our clients would pay you for to in order to advance them on their journey to being a star, what would it be?
I'll probably do some dance classes because my friends say I'm really good at freestyle, and I also wanted to do like an Asian style dance class because you don't really see a lot of K-pop or anime dances here, so I would like to probably do that to like get those who really like K-pop and J-pop and anime style dances. I'll probably like to start doing classes for that for those who don't really see it but they still want to do it, so I'll probably do like dance classes.
Okay, there we go. So what are some of the links that we can find you on?
You can find me on Kaleidoscope Chick. It's in lowercase letters. Kaleidoscope Chick on Instagram and Kaleidoscope Chick on TikTok. That's all I really got right now. She's helping me with my blog, so you're going to see me getting a blog soon. She says she'll have it by Sunday. So once I blog some things, she'll put the link to my blog as well.
All right, awesome. So this has been...
Diamond.
I'm happy, and that is...
Thankful.
All right, and this has been Happy Hour.
Hi.
Bye-bye.
Like, you know what I'm
Do you
saying?
Want him to re-ask the question?
Don't record me asking questions.
Well, yes, that's the whole thing.
You want him to re-ask the question?
We done with that.
No, man, come on. Keep saying what you were saying.
I had just bad too.
Why you wait till we stop recording to ask questions?
The question's over.
Let me just rephrase what I said again. Okay, he was asking me about any famous cosplayers I know, and I said there was one called Yaya Han who's very famous. I'm not sure of her nationality though, so I don't want to say and make anyone upset. So, but yeah, she's very famous. She's also done. It was a sci-fi show. I forgot what it was called. It was something with weapons or swords or something like that. It was years ago. And she also came to MumbleCon a few times, but I wasn't able to go, and I was upset because I didn't get the chance to see her. But I think she'd been doing it for like the early 90s, and I really admire her for as cosplayer as well. And so, and he was also asking me about other cosplayers I know. This one called Wreck-It Rodney. She's a very famous cosplayer too. You can find her on Instagram at Wreck-It Rodney. I also did a duet with her on TikTok. It was two dance videos, and I was nervous because I didn't think she would look at it. And but when I posted it, she was like, yes, girl. I'm like, oh, she likes my stuff. I was so happy she noticed me. I'm like, my senpai noticed me. And so she liked that, and I posted it on my Instagram, and she liked those too, and she also liked it too on TikTok, and that made me happy. There's some other cosplayers. There's some, I just can't think of any more right now. But I'm pretty sure there's a lot of cosplayers too that's roaming around this world that I would like to meet. But those are just the two on top of my head right now.
Okay. Anything else?
She's the Cosmo expert.
It's pronounced cosplay, it's not Cosmo. I'm gonna have the cosplay community come up here and beat you up for mispronouncing their stuff.
I might do some Jackie Chan shit on that.
Okay, we're gonna just stop right there because I don't want anybody to come up here and try to find us.
Aw, nobody's gonna try to find
him. Please, give my address.
Please don't find him and beat him up. Please don't. Please don't.
Ready.
No, please don't.
Hey, I got an army.
No. We're not doing this today.
I'm the one man army.
No, don't beat him up, please. I don't like violence. Don't beat him up, please.
I don't know what it was. No disrespect to the cosmos.
Cosplay. it's costume and play. Cosplay.
Cosplay.
There you go.
I like Jackie Chan. I was just asking a question.
You done? You got some more? I know you got some more.
Well, you can show my choreography. That's some money.
He said he wants to see some dancing.
Oh, okay. I'm like, you gotta translate that because I know what he was trying to say. You gotta give me a stretch.
I didn't say that.
I'm like, I gotta stretch
said
first.
That, but I wouldn't mind.
I mean, I gotta stretch first, and I gotta just find one of my songs I know and just go ahead and just have at it.
How about can you stretch and do it at the same time? But
I can't stretch and dance at the same time. No, you gotta
like a warm up thing, like.
Yeah.
Get into the groove, like.
Do you mean dance stretch?
Like, yeah, I guess, like, you just taking your time stretching to the music.
I mean, I guess I could. There's, like, when I was in middle school and I was a cheerleader, we stretched to Beyonce's Get Me Body. That's how I stretched.
You,
okay, like, stretched that
way. You wanna give us a demonstration in that corner?
You want me to do it right now?
Me?
You got the music?
You got music?
You got the interwebs to find that song?
What, you want me to acapella or something?
No!
I don't think I can record and play the music.
I was like, if I would have known, I would have brought my laptop, because I have it on my laptop, but I didn't have enough room in my bag to bring
it.
On the next episode. Yeah, well, we're going to play a video. We're going to play a video, one of your videos, after we get through with the questions.
Yay!
All right.
You done?
Okay.
All right.
Bye.
Why don't you say so? Didn't even know.